Good morning, everyone. Today is our last day at this house. We were doing some dog sitting and the view is so beautiful here. We are on Lake Washington. I was trying to catch the sunrise this morning, but I ended up sleeping in and missed it all. And Dakota has just been enjoying the view. It's so beautiful. Good girl, Dakota.
We just came to Pie Vegan Pizzeria's new location, and we got some buffalo chicken pizza pie with a
saucy sampler
appetizer. So exciting, looks so delicious.
So this is her old setup. It is a glass terrarium. Her little light upstairs. We are upgrading her to a wooden enclosure. I was informed that they're not supposed to be in glass terrariums because they get obsessed with what's around them. So we're building her a massive enclosure. Finishing up the... We're just here finishing up the enclosure. It's almost done. The bottom doesn't really matter how it looks like just because it's going to be under a tarp or a trash bag to hold the substrate in the moisture. And we got wood that wasn't treated or anything, that way the chemicals wouldn't affect our baby. And she's just here watching us. I really hope she loves it. Hi, baby. We're all done lining the enclosure. We put a shower liner so that the wood wouldn't be affected by the moisture, because I do have to spritz her enclosure every day. I try to do it every day. Sometimes I'll do it every other day just to keep the humidity up in her enclosure. So now we are pouring the Zoomed coconut husk. Now that we have the substrate all evenly spread, we're gonna go ahead and mist it just to add a little bit of moisture because the substrate is dry. We will go ahead and start adding all of her little decorations. We have a little hide for her just so that she can go to sleep there. We'll put it all the way there. And then Jake added these little planks on top because if she were to climb her little hide, she would actually be taller than the 8 inches of the plank on her enclosure. So she would climb out and fall out. So we went ahead and put the hide in that corner under this little plank there. All right, and then I also bought her a little ramp just so that she can have somewhere to soak, just kind of like a little pool. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in that corner, just right there. Actually, I'll put it on this side. Put it right there, just so that she can have somewhere to climb and swim if she wants to soak during the day. And then I'll also be adding her other little decoration that we have for her, just kind of spreading it around so she's familiar with her area. And then I'll be adding her dish bowls, and then we'll be putting her in and see how she likes it. This is what the setup looks like on the outside. I have put her little basking area. I just need to buy a little plate to go right here, I filled up her swimming pool with some water. I'm gonna have to put less right now just because I don't know how high the water is gonna rise when she actually climbed in there. And then I made sure to put some of her reptile safe droplets into her water just to make it safe for her to swim in. Her food will be here, and then she has her little cuddle rocks there, her enclosure over there, and then some extra little space to crawl and to explore as well. All right, this is her here, and I'm gonna go ahead and pick her up, and she looks like she is ready to crawl around. I'm gonna go ahead and see how she reacts to her enclosure. I'm just gonna leave it here for a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and give her a little worm just because I know that they're her favorite. She's already exploring around. But she loves her worms. She just sees them crawl and she knows what it is. Good girl. Make the funniest squeaking sounds. I'm also gonna go ahead and give her a strawberry just because they're her favorite, and I only give it to her as a treat, not her meal. She loves strawberries.
Good girl, hey, you want a treat?
Good girl!